also like this illness, and showing much more interest in differentiating. So at this time, sometimes we want these type of dogs to be controlled and to make them listen our orders, and also to control their libido, that means sexual needs. In order to control these type of things, we hope indirectly through vasectomy. So by going this procedure of vasectomy here, we will be performing only a surgical operation on vasectomy, but not on testes, so that testosterone will be remained and it will be continued producing by means of testes. So whenever this testosterone hormone is present in male dogs, they will be aggressive. At the same time, they even show sexual urge, but they are actually unable to reproduce. So this is the reason why most of the times we will be going through vasectomy. But the main indication is that most of the times today, and especially nowadays, we are not performing this vasectomy. We are mostly going only through castration, and sometimes this vasectomy is performed only under certain circumstances and only by specialized doctors, because some risks are involved while going through this vasectomy. And coming to the disadvantages of vasectomy, see, the main purpose of either castration or in order to remove the testes is because of to reduce the hormone testosterone, so that, and at the same time in order to reduce the spermatogenesis. When the testosterone hormone is reduced, the sexual urge and also the aggressiveness of the male animal will get reduced. And at the same time, testosterone hormone, which is responsible for the prostate gland growth, even as the testosterone decreases by means of this castration, indirectly prostate gland also decreases in its size. So most of the times in male dogs will come across prostate cancers. If this prostate cancer is nothing but because of this testosterone hormone. So in vasectomy, we will not remove the testes. That means testosterone hormone will be present, and sometimes we may come across these prostate cancers. So this is the reason why we will go through only castration and not vasectomy. In castration, we will remove testes, there will be no testosterone, and there will be no prostate gland growth. Prostate gland will be suppressed. This is the thing about vasectomy and castration. So sometimes, then we will necessitate that we have to only go through vasectomy. Owners will think that our dog should be aggressive, it should have sexual urge, but it should not reproduce. Then under certain circumstances, we have to go through this procedure of vasectomy. Coming to the first, this vasectomy procedure, let us start with anesthesia. So coming to the anesthesia, dog is kept under general anesthesia. Obviously, it is small animal, so we go through only general anesthesia. Here, coming to the general anesthesia, we use obviously atropine, xylazine, and ketamine. Coming to vasectomy, you always know the dose. 0.020 per kg.
Loading dose
called medial lobe. So coming to this medial lobe, it is nothing but the cockpit. It is given as cockpit. It is nothing but the combination of xylazine and ileum. For suppose here xylazine we are taking point and so in cochlea we have to take xylazine exactly half of the ileum dose, which means it is 0.25 kilo and ileum.
Thank you.
vasectomy procedure. So it's not easy task to easily isolate. Only persons who are experts in surgical procedures and who are repeated in such type of cases only can easily isolate this bad students and spotting. So these are actually being addressed and this is entirely covered by means of clinical examples. Here we have to capture these clinical examples and once we have to identify the bad students, once we identify bad students and traumatic on, we have to slowly ease this subject bad students from traumatic on up to about 0.5 centimeters. Separate the portion of bad students from traumatic on to a length of 0.5 centimeters. Once you got bad students separated from traumatic on, hold it by means of any other forces and now remember the procedure that first lie with these bad students on upper side and another lie with these on the other side. Give two ligations, one on the upper side and on the other side. Now, by means of scissors, cut here. Cut the portion in two ligations. This portion of bad students will be cut. This one you can see. So, here comes actually the clinical examination in which we can see this traumatic one. Here comes the neuter segments which we have incised. See, here we can see the portion of clinical examination which has been incised.
Completing the surgical procedure on one side, closes up that, closes skin, and once after stitching the skin of other side, repeat the same procedure on the other side. So here also on the other side, given incision on the particular side of the scrotum. Pre-scrotal side, given incision on the skin, given incision through the subcut, and expose the vas deferens and spermatic cord, isolate vas deferens from spermatic cord, ligate vas deferens and incise the vas deferens. If any other bleeding occurs, ligate those blood vessels, ligate it with the catheter, and now close the subcut and again close the skin. So once after exposing this spermatic cord and vas deferens on other one side, after performing surgical procedure on one side, after completing of that surgical procedure, do the same procedure on the other side. Has been completed, do not think that the entire procedure is completed. And once after this surgery,